A very good morning to all. Today we are going to start chapter 10, geometry. It's that revision. Okay. So let's study some concepts. Then we are going to apply those concepts on the questions. Arms. The two rays are called arms of an angle. Vertex. The common end point is called vertex of an angle. Angle. Two rays having an end point is called angle. The symbol of angle is this, and the we measure the angle by a degree, sine this is. Now I am going to relate this, what I have written here. Arms, what are the two rays? How rays? These are the rays, right? So the two rays are called arms of an angle. I can name A, B, C. So arms are AB, AC. Vertex. The common end point is called vertex of the angle. Common end point. This ray starts from here, ends here. Starts from here, ends here. This is the common point. So this is called vertex. Angle. Two rays having an end point is called angle. These two rays having an end point, and this is called angle. So this is a angle. Right? Rays. Vertex, angle. How we measure angle? The symbol is this, and like I can say angle A here, right? And the measure, if it is of 60 degrees, so I will write angle equals to 60 degrees. Here, so in exercise 10.1, we need to find out question number 1, arms and the vertex. So it's clear, arms and the vertex, I'm sure you can find it out, right? Next thing is, name the angles. Okay, naming the angles. What do you mean by naming the angles? How we name the angles? We always name the angle using the vertex where the angle actually starts, right? The angle is formed. For example, here the angle is, this is C, right? The angle is, we can say it is angle A or angle BAC and angle CAB, right? So there are three ways to name this angle. We can write by angle A or we can say BAC. Always this will be come in the middle, the vertex where the angle is formed. Then angle CAB, from here also you can write CAB, so both are right. This way you have to name the angles. Clear? I am sure you can do all questions on your own. I'll explain one more question with you. So we have a question where we have a figure. Okay. So we have this figure. I'm doing question number B part, third question. So it's D, E, F, G. D, E, F, G. And the middle is O. So you have to name all. Okay? So here, angles. We need to find the angles. So this is the angle, this is the angle, this is the angle, this is the angle. Then this is the angle, and this is the angle. So we have to name all. Let's start. Angle. O. Because all angles formed at O, so angle O. Second, angle BOF. Angle FOE. You will notice in every angle O will come in between. Angle GOE. Angle DOG. Then angle DOE. Then angle G O F. these are the angles formed in this figure. Clear? Just you have to name, make sure the vertex will come in between. So in every angle, the vertex comes in between. Okay? Now let's start exercise 10.3. 10.2 is to measure the protector. I'll tell you later on. So I'm sure this is clear. Now, exercise 10.3. In 10.3, we have a concept of types of angles. So, we need to find types of angles. So, there are different types of angles. First, right angle. Second, straight angle. Third, acute angle. And fourth, obtuse angle. Now let's study about each type of angle. Right angle, an angle that forms 90 degree angle is called a right angle. For example, if there are two arms standing just straight to each other, so this is right angle triangle. This is right angle, 90 degree right angle. Here, straight angle, angle that is formed on a straight line of 180 degree is called a straight angle. Acute angle, the angle that is formed less than 90 degree. So less than 90. For example, see, this was 90 degree, right? So less than this or this or this. These all angles are of less than 90. So acute angles. Obtuse angle, again this is 90, so angle formed here, this or this, these are obtuse, greater than 90. Alright, I repeat, right angle that is exactly equals to 90 degree, straight angle exactly equals to 180 degree, acute angle can be less, is of less than 90 degree, so there is no exact value, can be 60, can be 35, it can be 10, right? Less than 90, no exact value. Obtuse angle similarly, greater than 90, it can be 120, it can be 100, it can be 130, no exact value. Here, all the angles greater than 90, obtuse, less than 90, acute, straight angle equals to 180, and right angle equals to 90. Now, in the question, we have to identify the type of angle. So very easy, let me do any question, like exercise 10.3, I am doing question number A part 4. So like this figure is given and you have to find this angle. So this is acute angle, right? This is acute angle. See, I will tell you the way to do. Make a 90 degree angle and then find. See, it is less than, right? Less than 90, so acute angle. Clear? Okay. Let's go ahead. This concept will also be used in the types of triangles. So, please do remember. Question of B part also. In B part, there is one shape given. I'm going to do question number 3. There is one shape given. We make huts when we make landscapes. So this is kind of a hut. They are asking that in this shape, how many right angles? How many acute angles and how many obtuse angles are there? So, right angle 1, 2, 1, 2, 2 right angles. Acute angle, this one, 1. And obtuse, these are obtuse, 2. Sometimes if you have a confusion, you can make a line here and then you can find out. See, if this is 90 and this is greater than 90, so obtuse, so right angle, obtuse and acute. Clear? Alright, let's go ahead. Next is exercise 10.4. Again, 10.4 using protector we'll do later on. And let's do exercise 10.5. So in 10.5, you have types of triangles. Okay, first of all, the concept of 10.3 says about 10.5 polygons. What are polygons? Polygons is a closed figure. Simple. Polygon is what? Polygon is nothing but a closed figure. For example, see, is this a polygon? No, it's not closed. Now it becomes a polygon. Is this a polygon? No. Now it becomes a polygon. So polygon is nothing but a closed figure. Now if a polygon has three sides, it will become a triangle. For example, this is a triangle. 1, 2, 3 sides. When a polygon has four sides, it becomes quadrilateral. Quadrilateral. This is a quadrilateral. 1, 2, 3, 4. Now, pentagon. A polygon with a five sides, we called it as pentagon. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 6 sides. Hexagon. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Clear? So these are the names of the shapes given. All closed figure are called polygons. 3-sided triangle, 4-sided quadrilateral, 5-sided pentagon, and 6-sided hexagon. Now we need to find out regular and irregular pentagon. So the polygon that with sides of equal length. Regular polygon is having sides of equal length. And irregular sides of unequal length. Right? So when we have the polygon with sides of equal length, that is regular, otherwise it is irregular. Now we will study about types of triangles. Okay, let's study first types of quadrilateral. We are going to study about types of quadrilateral and types of triangle, these two types, right? So let's study about triangle first. So what is a triangle? Three-sided figure is called triangle. Three-sided polygon is called triangle. There are three different types of triangle. First, equilateral triangle. Equilateral. Second, isosceles triangle. And third, scalene triangle. Equilateral. Equal means where all three sides of triangle are equal. All three sides are equal. For example, if I make a triangle If this side is 5 cm, this is also 5, this is also 5. And this is a sign to show that these three sides are equal. Isosceles, two sides are equal. Again, I will make a triangle. This is 5, but this is 6. So 1 and 2, these two are equal. Scalene. All sides are unequal. Okay? Or you can say no side is equal. No sides are equal. If this is 5, this is 6, and this is 7. No side is equal. Clear? Types of triangle, equilateral, all three sides are equal. 5, 5, 5. Sign is this. Isosceles, two sides are equal. 5, 5, 6. It can be these two also, right? There is no rule. Scalene, no sides are equal. 5, 6, 7. Clear? Okay. Now let's study about types of. So we have a question regarding this type of first and second question of from this concept. So let us do one question. Exercise 10.5 A part, second question. So the question is given. We have a figure like this. This is 7 centimeter, 6 and 5. So can you see all sides are unequal? So which triangle it would be? Scalene. No side are equal or all sides are unequal. Clear? Very easy questions. Then we have a B part. Questions where you need to tell the angle. So let us do any. There's a figure. There's a triangle and the angle is mentioned. 110. So 110 is what? Greater than 90 degree. So it will be what? It is obtuse angle triangle. It is obtuse angle triangle. Clear? Okay, good. Now let's study about four-sided figure, that is our quadrilateral. So four-sided figure, quadrilateral. So there are different types of quadrilateral based on some rules. First we have a square. What is a square? A square is a figure whose all sides are equal. Okay? Like this. Find square around you. Right? Find square around you at in your home, in your classroom, around you. Find a square where all sides are equal. So the definition of square. Square has all sides are equal. Opposite sides parallel. And all angles are 90 degree. These all are 90 degree. What do you mean by parallel? Parallel means when two lines are parallel, that means they will never meet. They will never meet. Okay, so square has three properties. First, all angles are equal. Second, opposite sides are parallel. I am writing in short form. Parallel, we can write like this also. And third, all angles are of 90 degree. Clear? Let's go ahead. Second figure is of rhombus. Have you seen kites? I'm sure you love to play fly kites, right? What is the shape of a kite? Is a rhombus. See. It looks like a kite. So kite, rhombus. What is the property of rhombus? Again, all sides are equal. And opposite sides are parallel. So these two lines are parallel. Opposite, you know, that is in front of the other side. So again, first all angles are equal, all sides are equal, and second opposite sides are parallel. Okay, so we did about square and rhombus. Let's study about more. We have rectangle. In rectangle, okay, again find the rectangle at your home. You can see around you the rectangles. Rectangle is like this. opposite sides are equal. This is equal to this, this side is equal to this. We call this as length and we call it as breadth. So opposite sides are equal. Opposite sides are parallel also, and all angles are of 90 degrees. Clear? Next figure is of parallelogram. So I just said you what you mean by parallel. Parallelogram. Parallel means that lines never meet. So we make the lines which never meet. So in parallelogram, opposite sides are parallel. This comes like a slanting. Okay, it is not a right angle. So slanting. Opposite sides are equal and parallel. So this is equal to this. This is equal to this. Then we have a trapezium. The trapezium. In this trapezium, what we have? One pair of opposite sides is parallel. Means so which pair is parallel? This. This will meet. See if we extend, no, it will meet. So this is not parallel. These one pair of opposite sides are parallel. Clear? Square, rhombus, rectangle, parallelogram, trapezium. Now, how the question will come? You have to tell the type of quadrilateral based on a figure. So, let us do one question. Okay. I am doing D part. Question number 2. D part. Question number 2. So figure is given and there are lines like this. So I told you this means that all sides are equal. So from the figure can you see all sides are equal, angles are of 90 degree and opposite sides are parallel. So which figure? Yes, of course it is a square. Clear? Good. Let's go ahead. Exercise 10.6. Important. Very important exercise 10.6 about circle. So we are going to study about circles in this exercise 10.6. Okay. Circle. So a circle is a closed shape made by the curved line. Means if I make a line here and if I make a closed shape around this, so this becomes a circle. I'm not good at drawing, okay? So this is a circle. This point is called O, A and B. Now this O is what? Center of the circle. Now we are going to study about some parts of circle. Parts of circle. First, radius. Second, diameter. Third, relation between radius and diameter. Radius and diameter. Then we are going to study about chord and the last circumference. Let's study all radius. A line segment joining the center of a circle to any point on the circle is called radius. So a line segment joining the center, okay, to any point of the circle. Any point is can be here, can be here, can be here, can be here. So these all are radius. These are radius. Clear? Line segment joining the center to any point of the circle. Diameter. Again, a line segment joining any two points on a circle passing through the center, okay, means it can be this, it can be this. I'm making it again. This is a circle. So it can be this. This is a center. It should pass the center. This is not a radius diameter, okay? This is wrong. It should pass the center and join any two points on the circle. So diameter. Radius done, diameter done. Relationship between radius and diameter. So diameter is always 2 times the radius. Diameter is always 2 times the radius. Or you can say radius is half of diameter. Radius is half of diameter. For this means if the diameter, if the radius is 2, diameter will be 4. If the radius is 5, diameter will be 10. Here, if the diameter is 10, radius will be 5. Okay? So, this is very important. Next, chord. Now, what is chord? Chord is a line segment joining any two points, not necessarily through the center. Means not through the center. Okay? So, I made a diameter here, no? So, which is the chord? This is the chord. It is not passing from center. This can be a chord. This can be a chord. Right? Joining any two points. Circumference, again very important. There is a formula of circumference, and circumference means the boundary of the circle. See, if I have to cover this boundary, if I have to go through boundary of the circle, this is something called circumference. What is the formula of circumference? It is 2 pi r. Pi, I am calling this pi. What is pi? Pi is a constant value, that is a fixed value. Means radius can change, but pi will not change. It will remain same, and you have to learn it. The value of pi is 22 pi 7, or you can write 3.14. Whatever is comfortable for you to calculate. Here in this exercise only geometry, you need to do some calculations. Rest geometry is very scoring, no calculation, right? So we need to find this. There are three formulas. Diameter is twice of radius, radius is half of diameter, and circumference is 2 pi r, pi is 22 by 7 or 3.14. Let us do one question of each exercise. Of each part of exercise 10.6. So, I am writing the formulas on the right side as a rough part. You can also do in your exam. If you think that you can forget the formula, you write down. Radius is what? Start with diameter. Diameter is twice of radius. D diameter, R radius. Radius is half of diameter. Right? Then circumference is 2 pi r. Clear? Now question will come, find the diameter of the circle whose radius is given. Okay, so let me see one question. Okay, I am doing B part, question number 6. What is given? Diameter is given 7 cm. So we will write formula first. That we need to find what? We need to find the diameter. Radius is given. This is radius. This is very important. You can also do this mistake. Make sure what is given. If you will write diameter here, our question will be wrong. Okay? So what is given? Find the diameter whose radius is given below. So radius is this. So diameter, write formula first. Twice of radius. I am writing D. You need to write diameter. Okay? Then twice of radius is given, that is 7. 7 multiplied 2 is 14 centimeter. Important unit. Clear? Whatever unit is given here will come as it is. Second question. We need to find the radius of the circle when diameter is given. Okay, I am going to do this question same so that you can check it out. Now see, diameter comes out to be 14 now. So what I will do here, let's say that diameter 14 is given. And you need to calculate radius. So what is radius? Radius is nothing but half of diameter, D. So let us find 1 by 2 multiplied by 14 2, 7s are 14, so 7 centimeters. See, earlier radius was 7, diameter 14, now radius 7, so now diameter 14, so radius 7. Clear? Good. Next question, circumference. In circumference, you may be given diameter or you may be given radius. So, you have to see if radius is given, directly it will be added to the formula. But if diameter is given, first convert into radius and then add into the formula. I'll do two questions for you. Find the circumference where diameter is 4 cm. So, this is question number B. First, diameter is given 4 cm. You need to find the circumference. So, what you will write? Formula of circumference is 2 multiply pi multiply r. Here diameter is given, but here radius has to be find out. So no problem, we know the formula. What is radius? Radius is half of diameter. So half of 4. What will come? 2 cm. We got radius now. Now add into circumference. 2 pi into 2. 2. What is the pi value? Again, you can write down in rough if you forget. 22 by 7 or 3.14. So I am writing 22 by 7 multiply by 2. Once you solve this, you will get the answer. Clear? Okay. Now, okay, if radius is directly given, then it is easier to solve. Directly you will put the radius. Now the question next E part is, you need to find the diameter if circumference is given. Okay, so this question is little tricky, like you need to open up your minds and then apply. So find the diameter. We need to find what? Diameter. And then question E part and question number 1. So find the diameter with the given circumference. So circumference is given 94.2 cm. Clear? So next two, we know the formula of circumference. It's 2 pi r. Circumference is already given. So we have the answer with 94.2 equal to 2. What is the value of pi? 22 by 7 into r. Now you need to do some calculations. Always remember, what you need to do, radius we need to find out now. So we will take radius here, rest everything will go this side. So when something go opposite side, it becomes opposite. Means 7 is in the division, it will come in the multiplication. 94 multiplied by 7 divided by 22 into 2 equals to radius. This comes out to be radius. We need to find the diameter, but so find the diameter. Diameter is nothing but twice of radius. So twice of this all. Twice of 94.2 into 7 by 22 into 2. So you can do like this way also. Calculation you can do here also. Right? You need to solve this and you will get the answer. Centimeter. You have to write. Clear? Yeah, again I am saying you, geometry is very important. Scoring, there are very less calculations only in exercise 10.6. There are very less calculations to calculate diameter, radius and circumference. So you can score well, prepare hard, practice, study the concept. And I am sure you will get full marks in this chapter.